I see really a concatenation of tendencies and forces here at the end. Contradiction is going to rise excruciatingly, even beyond the excruciating present levels of contradiction. I think it's just going to get weirder and weirder and weirder, and finally it's going to be so weird that people are going to have to talk about how weird it is, Because eventually people are going to say, what the hell is going on? It's just too nuts. It's not enough to say it's nuts. You have to explain why it's so nuts. I look for the invention of artificial life, the cloning of human beings, possible contact with extraterrestrials, possible human immortality, and at the same time, appalling acts of brutality, genocide, race baiting, homophobia, famine, starvation, because the systems which are in place to keep the world sane are utterly inadequate to the forces that have been unleashed. The collapse of the socialist world, the rise of the internet, these are changes so immense, nobody could imagine them ever happening. Now that they have happened, nobody even bothers to mention what a big deal it is. So the good news is that as primates, we're incredibly adaptable to change. You put us in a desert, we survive. You put us in the jungle, we survive. Under Hitler, we survive. Under Nixon, we survive. We can put up with about anything. That's a good thing because we're going to be tested to the limits. And this is why the right wing is so alarmed. Because what they see going on is the breakdown of all tradition. All order, all sanctions, norms of behavior. And they're quite right that it's happening. But they're quite wrong to conclude that it should be resisted or is somehow evil. The mushroom said to me once and said, this is what it's like when a species prepares to depart for the organism. on this planet at its conclusion. And that's what we have, the fire in the madhouse at the end of time.